Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Today we will learn about how to scrap a website using Python and its wonderful libraries. So first of all, you have to install Python in your system, whether it is Windows or Linux or Mac. I'm using macOS, and so I will show you how to do web scrapping in Mac, although you can use the same methods in Windows or Linux. So first of all, you have to install Python in your system. So there is a wonderful package manager for macOS, which is Homebrew. So using Homebrew, you can install Python or any library that is needed for your program. So just use Homebrew or just go to Python, and here you will see the package link, download link according to your system. So here I have installed Python 3.7.1 in my system already. You can download it from here and install in your system. Now after installing Python, you can open your terminal in macOS or command prompt in Windows and type Python. This is to check the system version. Any previous Python version is installed in your system, so you can check like this, capital V. So this is the previous version that is installed in my system, and to check Python 3 version, which is the specific Python 3 version is installed in my system, I have to type Python 3 like this. Okay, spelling mistake. Python 3. This is the Python 3.7.2 version installed. I think I upgraded it. So you can check all the Python commands using this command, Python minus -h. So here are the commands that you can use using your system terminal to manipulate with the Python library. So after this, you have to install a wonderful library to scrap the websites. It is Beautiful Soap. This is the latest version, so I recommend to use the latest version for all the libraries that you use with your Python program. So from here, I will give the link in the description, so you can download the Beautiful Soap using this command in the terminal. Let's see. So because I have already installed Beautiful Soup 4, this is saying that already satisfied, you are already satisfied with this requirement. So this is the PIP, Python package manager. This is a very wonderful package manager to install any Python libraries in your system. You can also check which libraries are already installed in your system with this command, PIP space list. Let me resize it. These are the commands that I have already installed in my system. You can also install or uninstall these libraries using PIP. You can check the PIP help. These are the commands that you can use with your PIP, like this, install, PIP install, and this is the library name, PIP download, uninstall, freeze, list, show. All these are the wonderful commands that you can use. So after this, you have to use AlexML. This is the inbuilt library of Python that you can use with your Python data scrapping program. So we use this AlexML library to get the data from the Beautiful Soup object into HTML XML format. So I will show you how we use this, and this is also inbuilt library of Python requests. This we use to get or post the request to the server which we want to import in our system. So let's get started now. Now make a folder in your system anywhere and open that folder in VS Code. I'm using VS Code. So I have made a folder named test, and there I have two files, simple.html and scrap.py. So with in simple.html I have a simple, very simple HTML page. So here you can see that this is our HTML tag, this is the head section, this is the body section, and in body we have h1 tag, test website, some div tags like with article and two articles, and one footer section, and this is the very simple page. I will give you the link in the description, you can download from there. So we will use this page to scrap the data from this page to our system. So here you can see that we have a file named scrap.py. So these are the just two basic commands of the Python. First one is from VS4 import beautiful soup. So this one is importing the beautiful soup library in our code, and second is request, import request. Requests is I have told you that it is a library, Python library. So after this we have to open this file to read it. So with open simple.html as HTML file, this gives us simple HTML file as a object. So we need to convert it into HTML readable data. So we have to use AlexML library using beautiful soup. So beautiful soup HTML file as an object and then AlexML. So this will give us a soup variable which holds the complete HTML page. So let's see what it holds. Let's print it. Soup. Let's prettify it to view in a proper manner. Just it. Now we have to run this command. I'm already in the test folder. Python 3 scrap.py. So here you can see that we have complete page after this command from this tag to here. Now after this we don't just want the complete page, we have to scrap the data from the page. So let's comment it. After that, what if I want to print the title of the page? Soup, then title, then string. You can see that here, this is the title tag. So after, because the whole page is a variable under soup variable, so you have to use this like this. Soup title string. You have to, because we want title as a string. So now save it. See, test a sample website. Now we want h1 tag here, h1, but this giving us a complete h1 tag, but we want test website. So what you can do is type string test website. After that you have to find you want to find the div element. You can find like this, print soup.findDiv. So this will give us the complete div elements of the page. Now we want class footer. Comment on this. So here it is giving us the complete footer class. Now we will get H1 title here, H1 tag data here. So you have to use this type of syntax in the Python to get the data from any tag. If you are using ID, then you have to write here ID, but if you are using class, then you have to write here class underscore, because class is already used in the Python as a already a built-in keyword, so you can't use directly class. You have to write here class underscore. Here we get the H1 as a string here. Here we are scraping all the articles using for loop. So what I'm doing here is I'm running the for loop and I'll get the all articles using this class article under the div element, div tag. Here I'm getting all the articles using this command soap.findAll, and we will retrieve this using this element. Let's see. So first we want a for loop first article h2 a text. Here we have a link in h2 tag, so we are getting the content of the link here. So we will get all the headings of the all articles. Let's print it here. Here this is our article 1 and this is article 2. Now we will get summary and article both. Article 1, this is the summary of article 1, article 2, summary of article 2. If you want to give space, then you can do this like this. This is the space. So this is how we scrap the data using Python. We can also do this using any website, live website. We will do this in the next lecture. Thank you.